Terry. Got a taste?
For you, Davey. Max discount, huh? You just pay me later.
You're a prick. That's what you are. You leave her to drop your sprog while you lift it up in Oz.
Now then, he'll carve his niche and then he'll have time to be Father of the Year.
Yeah.
Maybe you and me can do more business too, Greg, when I go international. Conquer the world.
Sounds like a plan.
Don't worry about it. Everything's going to be fine, I promise. We'll give you some money.
Stay out of it, babe. It's none of our business. Don't look so worried. Not like Greg. I know how to treat a woman.
For now, maybe. Bonnie, though, was a one-man girl. And she wouldn't always be number one in Marty's harem. The women were all part of the lifestyle, and there'd be lots of them. As the joints were passed around, so were the girls.
Oh, bloody hell, Andy!
And most of them seemed to enjoy it. Only Isabel and Doug Wilson were forever. Still, when you start tasting your own product, it's a slippery slope. Before long, the taste buds shrivel and you look for something sharper, which is what Terry Clark was planning to cash in on.
You're running a pension scheme, Terry. Maybe I can help. Let's talk.
To our continued investment in cannabis sativa. Success!
Success!
Like the Wilsons, Norma had developed a real taste for Terry's imported product. Amazing how many heart attacks there are in New Zealand. Terry's loss was everybody else's gain. And for Marty and Andy, for now, the cannabis beat went on. Things were getting out of hand, and as far as the papers were concerned, that was all down to us. To mix a couple of clichés, the cat wasn't exactly among the pigeons, but it sure as hell was out of the bag.
What's this bullshit?
It's come from somebody. Yeah, well, it wasn't here, right? It's the fifth time this month. Every bust we make, we find these.
Start with pot and hello, heroin.
No. Look, I've worked undercover.
Here we go.
I know the scene. Kiwis, my children, are a race of potheads.
People move with the times.
Why, we don't.
Yes, we do. She's got a desk, hasn't she?
All I want, Clive, is the will to deal with this.
Nobody seems keen.
I thought Skinner was.
Do you hear that? Voice in the wilderness.
Not quite. Your man's starting to listen. To us and the drug squad.
Are you talking heroin?
Look. The usual run of things is to wait till the problem becomes the major problem. And right now, the major problem is this Thai product. You and Carol are parting company, Clive. You two have been requested by CIS.
To work on drugs?
Unfortunately, that's not part of their brief.
You just got handed the shit stick, sticky end first. CIS is still focused on the old school. You two are going to be sitting in cars doing surveillance on safe crackers until your asses are spread like pancakes. Be careful what you wish for.
Where the hell is our ride? Freezing my balls off. It's late.
We were still getting lucky occasionally, like when a routine patrol scored 30,000 sticks. Fair old price on the street.
Oh, please!
$500,000, that's how much you cost us, you piece of shit.
A good beating was the order of the day. Actual dead bodies hadn't started to mount up yet. None we knew of, anyway.
Please! My girlfriend's alarm clock didn't go off.
Die!
You better get a new fucking alarm clock, eh?
I only asked you to find out what happened.
Well, we're as gentle as we could be, considering.
You didn't kill him, did you?
Well, you want us to? We can go back and finish it.
So, Marty, big hole in the budget.
Short-term supply problem and a bit of a glitch in the cash flow. Thanks for coming over. You up for this?
Sure. I can supply 20, 25 grand for a pickup. Local product from South Auckland. Bridge the gap till Jack's next run.
Cabbage. Punters won't be happy.
It's better than nothing. Thanks, Peter. I might make a pickup or two myself.
Oh, you think that's wise?
It's good business, Terry. Show my face on the street a bit. You blokes have been letting the troops get slack. It's time they're inspired.
Aye. They need a bit of a wake-up call.
Or decent clocks.
Which is where we came in. Marty was about to get a wake-up call of his own. Someone had a whole separate agenda, and Mr. Johnston was starting to become a pain in the bum.
Max, I'm so sorry. I completely...
Write this down.
Who is this?
Jag. Burgundy. BC5534. Follow it tonight.
Now, why would I want to do that?
You interested in drugs? BC5534. Look up the address.
Ben, I got a tip. On this ridge, I get an address. Intel drugs. Could be a joint op.
Ben, you want to maintain line of sight? So will we. Sarge will cover up the road, over.
Okay, it's not too far.
Yes, Mum.
Just hold for my call.
Any ideas on your tipster?
No. Definitely Kiwi, not foreign.
Here we go.
You want a nick?
Yeah.
You got what I need. Don't worry about that, mate.
Excellent. Okay, boys and girls, crunch time.
It's the right size there?
Excellent.
Great, you got some money?
I'll receive.
Bravo Charlie 5534. We're coming up to the bridge. You're nearly in position.
Affirmative.
Sarge, car's nearly in position. You come in behind us, over. We've got the bastard.
You're under arrest.
Fucker. Should never have worn the platforms. Could have been long gone.
Yeah, Marty something. King's on cranes, Matty, you back? What was in the bag?
What bag? I thought the bloke had broken down. Huh. Stopped to help.
Sure you did.
I'm on the shirt, Angel.
Hey,
Guys! That bag! Yeah, take it to the shore!
Don't know what your mates are smoking at. You either.
You got it, mate.
Simple. Maybe not. It's all circumstantial. Everything you've got.
We'll see about that.
Waiting here. We retrieved about 50% of these from the chase.
So some pothead would have got very lucky.
They're not much use, especially when it comes to Johnston.
Yeah, all local products, same as the sack from the water.
Makes it hard for us to tie these guys to the imports.
Still, they're not going to be able to claim all this for personal use, are they? Who knows? Johnston's lawyer's downstairs. He wants to walk him.
Start the paperwork.
Yeah. What'd they say?
Not enough evidence he was receiving the dope. They reckon we haven't got a dog show. We try to oppose bail in court tomorrow and the judge will laugh in our faces.
We can try. Get him held over on remand while we lean on our jag driver. He might cut a deal.
We can try.
Not my best angle.
It'll be fine for the judge.
Well, I'm obviously not fine enough.
Why have you and Carol got the hots for this bloke?
We both knew him from way back. He was a thief and a liar then, and look at him now. He's a player. All grown up.
If Carol had been successful at having Marty refused bail, it might have taken him a lot longer to ramp things up. As it was, he had money to invest and a business to build. And the system had handed him an opportunity to build it on a solid gold plate.
Saturday on 3, Michael Mann brings his groundbreaking TV series to film in the No Rules, No Order world of Miami Vice at 8:30. But up next, we bring you up to date with the latest in news and entertainment in Nightline.
See more of New Zealand on air.